And when the young man arrived in his mother's country, he rejoiced there in the honor which he received, and in the gifts that were made to him. And when the people saw him, they thought him to be the perfect likeness of King Solomon. And they made obeisance to him, and they said to him, Hail, the royal father liveth. And they brought to him gifts and offerings, fatted cattle and food, as to their king. And the people of the whole country of Gaza, as far as the border of Judah, were stirred up, and they said, This is King Solomon. And there were some who said, The king is in Jerusalem building his house. Now he had finished building the house of God. And others said, This is Solomon the king, the son of David. And they were perplexed, and they disputed with one another. And they sent off spies mounted on horses, who were to seek out King Solomon, and to find out if he were actually in Jerusalem, or if he were with them in Gaza. And the spies came to the watchmen of the city of Jerusalem, and they found King Solomon there, and they made obeisance to him, and they said to him, Hail, may the royal father live. Our country is disturbed because there hath come into it a merchant who resembleth thee in form and appearance, without the smallest alteration or variation. He resembleth thee in noble carriage and in splendid form, and in stature and in goodly appearance. He lacketh nothing in respect of these, and is in no way different from thyself. His eyes are gladsome, like to those of a man who hath drunk wine. His legs are graceful and slender, and the tower of his neck is like to the tower of David thy father. He is like to thee exactly in every respect, and every member of his whole body is like to thine. And King Solomon answered and said to them, Where is it then that he wisheth to go? And they answered and said to him, We have not inquired of him, for he is awesome like thyself. But his own people, when we asked them, Whence have ye come, and whither do ye go? Said, We have come from the dominions of Kandake and Ethiopia, and we are going to the country of Judah to King Solomon. And when King Solomon heard this, his heart was perturbed, and he was glad in his soul. For in those days he had no children, except a boy who was 7 years old, and whose name was Rehoboam. It happened to Solomon, even as Paul stated, saying, God hath made foolishness the wisdom of this world. For Solomon had made a plan in his wisdom, and said, By 1,000 women I shall beget 1,000 men children, and I shall inherit the countries of the enemy, and I will overthrow their idols. But God only gave him 3 children. His eldest son was the king of Ethiopia, the son of the queen of Ethiopia, and was the firstborn of whom God spake prophetically. God sware to David in righteousness, and repented not. Oh, the fruit of thy body will I make to sit upon thy throne. And God gave to David his servant grace before him, and granted to him that there should sit upon the throne of the Godhead one of his seed in the flesh, from the virgin, and should judge the living and the dead, and reward every man according to his work, one to whom praise is meet, our Lord Jesus Christus, forever and ever. Amen. And he gave him one on the earth who should become king over the tabernacle of the law of the holy heavenly Zion, that is to say, the king of Ethiopia. And as for those who reigned, who were not of Israel, that was due to the transgression of the law and the commandment, wherein God was not pleased. Whereat God was not pleased. How King Solomon sent to his son the commander of his army. And Solomon the king sent the commander of his army, on whose hand he was wont to lean, with gifts and meat and drink, to entertain that traveler. And the commander set out with a great number of wagons, and he became to Bayan Lekem, and embraced him, and gave him everything that Solomon the king had sent to him. And he said to him, Make haste and come with me, for the heart of the king is burnt up with fire with the love of thee. Peradventure he will find out for himself whether thou art his own son or his brother. For in thine appearance and in thy conversation or manner, thou art in no way different from him. And now rise up quickly, for my lord the king said to me, haste and bring him. And bring him hither to me in honor and comfort, and with suitable service, and in joy and gladness. And the young man answered and said to him, I thank God, the Lord of Israel, that I have found grace with my lord the king. Without having seen his face, his word hath rejoiced me. And now I will put my trust in the Lord of Israel, that he will show me thee, king, and will bring me back safely to my mother, the queen, and to my country, Ethiopia. And Joash, the son of Yadohe, the commander of the army of King Solomon, answered and said to Baalim-lekem, my lord, this is a very small matter, and thou wilt find far greater joy and pleasure with my lord, the king. And as concerning what thou sayest, my mother and my country, Solomon, the king, is better than thy mother, and this our country is better than thy country. And as for thy country, we have heard that it is a land of cold and cloud, and a country of glare and burning heat, and a region of snow and ice. And when the sons of Noah, Shem and Ham and Japheth divided the world among them, they looked on thy country with wisdom and saw that, although it was spacious and broad, it was a land of whirlwind and the burning heat, and therefore gave it to Canaan, the son of Ham, as a portion for him and his seed forever. But the land that is ours is the land of inheritance, the promised land which God hath given to us according to the oath that he swore to our fathers, a land flowing with milk and honey, where sustenance is ours without anxiety, a land that yieldeth fruit of every kind in its season without exhausting labor, a land which God keepeth watch over continually from one year to the beginning of the revolution of the next. All this is thine, and we are thine, and we will be thine heirs, and thou shalt dwell in our country, for thou art the seed of David, the Lord of my God, and to thee belongeth this throne of Israel. And the headman of the merchant Tamrim answered and said to Banaiah, our country is the better. The air climate of our country is good, for it is without burning heat and fire, and the water of our country is good and sweet and floweth in rivers. Moreover, the tops of our mountains run with water. And we do not do as ye do in your country. That is to say, dig very deep wells in search of water. And we do not die through the heat of the sun, but even at noonday we hunt wild animals, namely the wild buffaloes and gazelles and birds and small animals. And in the winter, God taketh heed to us from one year to the beginning of the course of the next. And in the springtime, the people eat what they have trodden with the foot, as in the land of Egypt. And as for our trees, they produce good crops of fruit, and the wheat, and the barley, and all our fruit, and cattle are good and wonderful. But there is one thing that ye have wherein ye are better than we are, namely wisdom, and because of it we are journeying to you. And Joash Benaiah, the commander of the army of King Solomon, answered, saying, what is better than wisdom? For wisdom hath founded the earth, and made strong the heavens, and fettered the waves of the sea, so that it might not cover the earth. However, rise up, and let us go to my lord, for his heart is greatly moved by love for thee. And he hath sent me to bring thee to him with all the speed possible. And the son of the queen rose up and arrayed Joash Benaiah, the son of Yodahe, and the 50 men who were in his retinue, in gorgeous raiment, and they rose up to go to Jerusalem to Solomon the king. And when they came nigh to the place where the horses were exercised and trained, Benaiah the son of Yodahe went on in front and came to the place where Solomon was, and he told him that the son of the queen was well favored in his appearance, and that his voice was pleasant, and that he resembled him in form, and that his whole bearing was exceedingly noble. And the king said to him, Where is he? Did I not send thee forth to bring him as quickly as possible? And Benaiah said to him, He is here, I will bring him quickly. And Benaiah went and said to the young man, Rise up, O my master, and come. And making Baina Lechem to go quickly, he brought him to the king's gate. And when all the soldiers saw him, they made obeisance to him. And they said, Behold, King Solomon hath gone forth from his abode. And when the men who were inside came forth, they marveled. And they went back to their places. And again they saw the king upon his throne. And wondering, they went forth again and looked at the young man, and they were incapable of speaking and of saying anything. And when Benaiah the son of Jehoiada came in again to announce the king the arrival of the young man, there was none standing before the king, but all of Israel had thronged outside to see him. How King Solomon held intercourse with his son. And Benaiah the son of Jehoiada went out and brought Bain Lechem inside. And when King Solomon saw him, he rose up and moved forward to welcome him. And he loosed the band of his apparel from his shoulder, and he embraced him with his hands resting on his breast. And he kissed his mouth and forehead and eyes, and he said to him, Behold, my father David hath renewed his youth and hath risen from the dead. And Solomon the king turned round to those who had announced the arrival of the young man. And he said to them, Ye said to me, He resembleth thee, but this is not my stature, but the stature of David my father in the days of his early manhood. And he is handsomer than I am. And Solomon the king rose up straightway, and he went into his chamber. And he arrayed the young man in apparel made of cloth embroidered with gold, and a belt of gold. And he set a crown upon his head, and a ring upon his finger, and having arrayed him in glorious apparel, which bewitched the eyes, he seated him upon his throne, that he might be equal in rank to himself. And he said to the nobles and officers of Israel, O ye who threat me with contumely among yourselves, and say that I have no son, look ye, this is my son, the fruit that hath gone from my body, whom God, the Lord of Israel, hath given me, when I expected it not. And his nobles answered and said to him, Blessed be the mother who hath brought forth this young man, and blessed be the day wherein thou hast union with the mother of this young man. For there hath risen upon us from the root of Jesse a shining man, who shall be king of the posterity of our posterity of his seed. Concerning his father, none shall ask questions, and none shall say, Whence is his coming? Verily, he is an Israelite of the seed of David, fashioned perfectly in the likeness of his father's form and appearance. We are his servants, and he shall be our king. And they brought to him gifts, each according to his greatness. And the young man took the ring which his mother had given him when they were alone together. And he said to his father, Take this ring, and remember the word which thou didst speak to the queen, and give to us a portion of the fringe of the covering of the tabernacle of the law of God, so that we may worship it all our days, and all those who are subject to us, and those who are in the kingdom of the queen. And the king answered and said to him, Why givest thou me the ring as a sign? Without thy giving me a sign, I discovered the likeness of thy form to myself. For thou art indeed my son. And the merchant Tamrim spoke again to King Solomon, saying, Hearken, O king, to the message which thy handmaiden, the queen, my mistress, sent by me. Take this young man, anoint him, consecrate him, and bless him, and make him king over our country, and give him the command that a woman shall never again reign in his country, and send him back in peace. And peace be with the might of thy kingdom, and with thy brilliant wisdom. As for me, I never wished that he should come where thou art, but he urged me exceedingly that he should be allowed to come to thee. And besides, I was afraid for him lest he should fall sick on the journey, either through thirst for water or the heat of the sun, and I should bring my gray hairs down to the grave with sorrow. Then I put my trust in the holy heavenly Zion, the tabernacle of the law of God, that thou shalt not withhold it in thy wisdom. For thy nobles cannot return to their houses and look upon their children by reason of the abundance of wisdom and food which thou givest them, according to their desire. And they say, the table of Solomon is better for us than enjoying and gratifying ourselves in our own houses. And because of this, I, through my fear, sought protection so that thou mightest not establish him with thee, but mightest send him back to me in peace, without sickness and suffering, in love and in peace, that my heart might rejoice at having encountered thee. And the king answered and said to him, besides traveling with him and suckling him, what else hath a woman to do with a son? A daughter belongeth to the mother, and a boy to the father. God cursed Eve, saying, bring forth children in anguish, and with sorrow of heart, and after thy bringing forth shall take place thy return to thy husband. With an oath he said, bring forth, and having sworn thy return to thy husband shall follow. As for my son, I will not give him to the queen, but I will make him king over Israel, for this is my firstborn, the first of my race, whom God hath given me. And then Solomon sent to the young man evening and morning, dainties, meats, and apparels of honor, and gold and silver. And he said to him, it is better for thee to dwell here in our country with us, where the house of God is, and where the tabernacle of the law of God is, and where God dwelleth. And the young man, his son, sent a message to him, saying, gold and silver and rich apparel are not wanting in our country, but I came hither in order to hear thy wisdom, and to see thy face, and to salute thee, and to pay homage to thy kingdom, and to make obeisance to thee. And then I intended thee to send me away to my mother and to my own country, for no man hateth the place where he was born, and everyone loveth the things of his native country. And though thou givest me dainty meats, I do not love them, and they are not suitable for my body. But the meats whereby I grow and become strong are those that are gratifying to me. And although thy country pleaseth me, as doth a garden, yet it is not my heart gratified therewith. The mountains of the land of my mother, where I was born, are far better in my sight. And as for the tabernacle of the God of Israel, if I adore it where I am, it will give me glory. And I shall look upon the house of God, which thou hast builded, and I will make offering and make supplication to it there. And as for Zion, the tabernacle of the law of God, give me a portion. Give me a portion of the fringe of the covering thereof, and I will worship it with my mother, and with all those who are subject to my sovereignty. For my lady, the queen, hath already rooted out all those who served idols, and those who worship strange objects and stones and trees. And she hath rooted them out, and hath brought them to Zion, the tabernacle of the law of God. For she had heard from thee, and had learned, and she did according to thy word. And we worship God. And the king was not able to make his son consent to remain in Jerusalem with all his persuading. How Solomon asked his son questions. And again Solomon held converse with his son when he was alone, and when he said to him, why dost thou wish to depart from me? What dost thou lack here, that thou wouldest go to the country of the heathen? And what is it that driveth thee to forsake the kingdom of Israel? And his son answered and said to him, it is impossible for me to live here. Nay, I must go to my mother, thou favoring me with thy blessing. For thou hast a son who is better than I am, namely Rehoboam, who was born of thy wife lawfully, whilst my mother is not thy wife according to the law. And the king answered and said to him, since thou speakest in this wise, according to the law, I myself am not the son of my father David, for he took the wife of another man who he cause to be slain in battle, and he begot me by her. But God is compassionate, and he hath forgiven him. Who is wickeder and more foolish than men? And who is as compassionate and as wise as God? God hath made me of my father, and thee hath made he of me, according to his will. And as for thee, O my son, thou fear of our Lord God, do not violence to the face of thy father, so that in times to come thou mayest not meet with violence from him that shall go forth from thy loins, and that thy seed may prosper upon the earth. My son Rehoboam is a boy, 6 years old, and thou art my firstborn son, and thou hast come to reign, and to lift up the spear of him that begot thee. Behold, I have been reigning for 29 years, and thy mother came to me in the 7th year of my kingdom. And please God, he shall make me to attain the span of the days of my father. And when I shall be gathered to my fathers, thou shalt sit upon my throne, and thou shalt reign in my stead. And the elders of Israel shall love thee exceedingly. And I will make a marriage for thee, and I will give thee as many queens and concubines as thou desirest. And thou shalt be blessed in the land of inheritance with the blessing that God gave to our fathers, even as he covenanted with Noah, his servant, and with Abraham, his friend, and the righteous men, their descendants, after them down to David, my father. Thou seest me a weak man upon the throne of my fathers, and thou shalt be like myself after me, and thou shalt judge nations without number, and families that cannot be counted. And the tabernacle of the God of Israel shall belong to thee and to thy seed, whereto thou shalt make offerings and make prayers to ascend. And God shall dwell within it for ever, and shall hear thy prayers therein. And thou shalt do the good pleasure of God therein, and thy remembrance shall be in it from generation to generation. And his son answered and said to him, O my Lord, it is impossible for me to leave my country and my mother, for my mother made me to swear by her breast that I would not remain here, but would return to her quickly, and also that I would not marry a wife here. And the tabernacle of the God of Israel shall bless me wheresoever I shall be, and thy prayers shall accompany me whithersoever I go. I desire to see thy face, and to hear thy voice, and to receive thy blessing. And now I desire to depart to my mother in safety. How the king planned to send away his son with the children of the nobles. And then Solomon the king went back into his house, and he caused to be gathered together his counselors and his officers and the elders of his kingdom. And he said to them, I am not able to make this young man consent to dwell here. And now hearken ye to me, and to what I shall say to you. Come, let us make him king of the country of Ethiopia. Together with your children, ye sit on my right hand and on my left hand. And in the like manner, the eldest of your children shall sit on his right hand and on his left hand. Come, O ye counselors and officers, let us give him your firstborn children, and he shall have two kingdoms. I will rule here with you, and our children shall reign there. And I put my trust in God, that a third time he will give me seed, and that a third king will be to me. Now Baltasar, the king of Rome, wisheth that I would give my son to his daughter, and to make him with his daughter king over the whole country of Rome. For besides her he hath no other child, and he hath sworn that he will only make king a man who is of the seed of David, my father. And if we rule, there we shall be three kings, and Rehoboam shall reign here over Israel. For thus saith the prophecy of David, my father, the seed of Solomon shall become three heads of kingdoms upon the earth, and we will send to them priests, and we will ordain laws for them. And they shall worship and serve the God of Israel under the three royal heads. And God shall be praised by the race of his people Israel, and be exalted in all the earth, even as my father wrote in his book, saying, Tell the nations that God is king, And again he said, Announce to the peoples his work, praise him, and sing ye to him. And again he said, Praise God with a new song. His praise is in the congregation of the righteous. Israel shall rejoice in his Creator. To us belongeth the glory of sovereignty, and we will praise our Creator. And the nations who serve idols shall look upon us, and they shall fear us, and make us kings over them, and they shall praise God and fear him. And now come ye, let us make this young man king, and let us send him away with your children, ye who possess wealth and position. According to the position and wealth that ye have here, shall your children rule there. And they shall see the ordering of royalty, and we will establish them according to our law, and we will direct them and give them commands and send them away to reign there. And the priests and the officers and the counselors answered and said to him, Do thou send thy firstborn, and we will send our children also according to thy wish? Who can resist the commandment of God and the king? They are servants of thee, and of thy seed, as thou hast proclaimed. If thou wishest, thou canst sell them and their mothers to be slaves. It is not for us to transgress thy command, and the command of the Lord thy God. And then they made ready to do for them, their children, what it was right to do, and to send them into the country of Ethiopia, so that they might reign there, and dwell there forever, they and their seed from generation to generation. How they made the son of Solomon king. And they made ready the ointment of the oil of kingship, and the sounds of the large horn, and the small horn, and the flute, and the pipes, and the harp, and the drum filled the air. And the city resounded with cries of joy and gladness. And they brought the young man into the Holy of Holies, and he laid hold upon the horns of the altar. And sovereignty was given to him by the mouth of Zadok the priest, and by the mouth of Benaniah the priest, the commander of the army of King Solomon. And he anointed him with the holy oil of the ointment of kingship. And he went out from the house of the Lord, and they called his name David, for the name of a king came to him by the law. And they made him to ride upon the mule of King Solomon, and they led him round about the city, and said, We have appointed thee from this moment. And then they cried out to him, Bah, long live the royal father. And there were some who said, It is meet and right that thy dominion of Ethiopia shall be from the river of Egypt to the west of the sun, to the setting sun. Blessed be thy seed upon the earth, and from Shoah to the east of India, for thou wilt please the people of these lands. And the Lord God of Israel shall be to thee a guide, and the tabernacle of the law of God shall be with all that thou lookest upon, and all thine enemies and foes shall be overthrown before thee, and completion and finish shall be to thee and to thy seed after thee. Thou shalt judge many nations, and none shall judge thee. And against his father blessed him, and said to him, The blessing of heaven and earth shall be thy blessing. And all the congregation of Israel said, Amen. And his father also said to Zadok the priest, Make him to know and to tell him concerning the judgment and decree of God, which he shall observe there in Ethiopia. How Zadok the priest gave commands to David the king. And Zadok the priest answered and said to the young man, Hearken to what I shall say to thee. And if thou wilt perform it, thou shalt live to God. And if thou dost not, God will punish thee. And thou shalt become the least of all the nations, and thou shalt be vanquished by thy foes. And God shall turn away his face from thee, and thou shalt be dismayed and sad and sorrowful in thy heart, and thy sleep shall be without refreshing and health. And hearken to the word of God, and perform it, and withdraw not thyself either to the right hand or the left, in respect of that which we command thee this day, and thou shalt serve no other god. And if thou wilt not hear the word of God, then hearken to all the curses here mentioned, which shall come upon thee. Cursed shalt thou be in the field, cursed shalt thou be in the city, cursed shall be the fruit of thy land, cursed shall be the fruit of thy belly, and the herds of thy cattle, and the flocks of thy sheep. And God shall send upon thee famine and pestilence, and he shall destroy that whereto thou hast put thine hand, until at length he shall destroy thee, because thou hast not hearkened to his word. And the heavens which are above thee shall become brass, and the earth which is beneath thee shall become iron, and God shall make the rain which should fall upon thy land to be darkness only, and dust shall descend from heaven upon the earth. It shall cover thee up and destroy thee, and thou shalt be smitten in battle before thine enemies. Thou shalt go forth to attack them by one road, and by seven ways shalt thou take thy flight before their faces, and thou shalt be routed, and they dead, and thy dead body shall become food for the fowl of the heavens, and there shall be none to bury thee, and God shall punish thee with sores of leprosy, and with the wasting disease, and with the fever that destroyeth, and with the punishment, plagues of Egypt, and with blindness and terror of heart. And thou shalt grope about by day like a blind man in the darkness, and thou shalt find none to help thee in thy trouble. Thou shalt marry a wife, and another man shall carry her away from thee by force. Thou shalt build a house, and shalt not dwell therein. And thou shalt plant a vineyard, and shalt not harvest the grapes thereof. Men shall slay thy fat oxen before thine eyes, and thou shalt not eat of their flesh. Men shall swatch away thine ass, and shall not bring him back to thee. Thy sheep shall run to the slaves and to thine enemy, and thou shalt find none to help thee. And thy sons and thy daughters shall follow other people, and thou shalt see with thine own eyes how they are smitten, and shall be able to do nothing. An enemy whom thou knowest not shall devour the food of thy land and thy labor, and thou shalt not be able to prevent him. And thou shalt become a man of suffering and calamity. When the day dawneth, thou shalt say, would that the evening had come. And when the evening cometh, thou shalt say, would that the morning had come, through the greatness of fear. All these things shall come upon thee, if thou wilt not hearken to the word of the Lord. But if thou wilt truly hearken to the word of the Lord, hear thou, the goodness of God shall find thee, and thou shalt rule the countries of the enemies, and thou shalt inherit everlasting glory from the Lord of God of Israel, who ruleth everything. For he honoreth him that honoreth him, and he loveth him that loveth him. For he is the Lord of death and of life, and he directed and ruled all the world with his wisdom and his power and his mighty arm. Concerning the blessing of kings. Hearken thou now to the blessing that shall come upon thee, if thou wilt do the will of God. Thou shalt be blessed in all thy ways. Blessed shalt thou be in the city. Blessed shalt thou be in the field. Blessed shalt thou be in thy house. Blessed shalt thou be outside it. And blessed shall be the fruit of thy belly. And those who were gathered together said, Amen. Blessed shall be the fruit of thy land. Amen. Blessed shall be the fountains of thy waters. Amen. Blessed shall be the fruit that thou hast planted. Amen. Blessed shall be thy cattle runs and the flocks of thy sheep. Amen. Blessed shall be the granaries of thy barns. Amen. Blessed shalt thou be in thy coming in. Amen. Blessed shalt thou be in thy going forth. Amen. And God shall bring to thee thine enemies who have risen up against thee, and they shall be trodden small beneath thy feet. Amen. And God shall send his blessing on thy houses and on everything to which thou hast put thine hand. Amen. And God shall multiply for thee good things, namely children of thy body, produce of thy land, and births among thy flocks and herds. Amen. And in the land which he swore to give to thy fathers, He will give thee according to the days of heaven. Amen. And God shall open for thee the storehouse of the blessing of heavens, and he shall give thee blessed rain, and shall bless the fruit of thy labor. Amen. Thou shalt lend to many peoples, but thou shalt not borrow. Amen. Thou shalt rule over many nations, but they shall not rule over thee. Amen. And God shall set thee at the head and not at the tail, and thou shalt be at the top and not at the bottom. Amen. And thou shalt gather together of every blessing of the land for thy flocks and herds, and thou shalt take the spoil of the nations for thine army, and they shall bow down to thee, to the face of the earth, to thy sovereignty, because of the greatness of thy glory. Thine honor shall rise up like Sedar, and like the morning star. Thy brilliance of thy glory shall be before all the nations of the earth, and before every tribe of thy people Israel. For God shall be with thee in all thy ways, and he will perform thy will in everything that thou determinest. And thou shalt inherit the countries of thine enemies, and the greatness of thy people shall be praised because of the greatness of thine awesomeness, and because of the multitude of thy soldiers. And all those who do not perform the will of God will fear thee, because thou dost do his will, and dost serve him. And therefore he will give thee great majesty in the sight of those who see thee. Their hearts shall tremble before the bridle of thy horses, and the quiver of thy bow, and the glitter of thy shield, and they shall bow down to the face of the earth, for their hearts shall be terrified at the sight of thy majesty. And when those who are in the mountains see thee afar off, they shall come down to the plain, and those who are on the seas and in the deep waters shall come forth, so that the Lord may bring them into thy hand, because they have transgressed the command of God. And thou, when thou doest his will, shalt receive from him everything for which thou hast asked. For his commandment he will grant thee the petition of thy heart, and everything that thou seekest thou shalt receive from him, for he is the good one to the good, and the compassionate to the compassionate. And he doeth the will of those who fear him, and he giveth a reward to those who wait patiently for him. Be patient in respect of wrath, and at the end he will make thee to rejoice. Love righteousness, and he will make life to blossom. Be patient in respect of wrath, and at the end he will make thee to rejoice. Love righteousness, and he will make life to blossom for thee. Be a good man to the good, and a reprover of sinners, and put aside the wickedness of the evil man by rebuking and correcting him. And condemn and disgrace the evil man who doeth violence to his neighbor in the court of law. And do justice to the poor man and to the orphans, and release them from the hand of him that doeth them wrong, and deliver him that is forsaken, and the man who is in misery, and release him from the hand of him that causeth him to suffer. Judge not with partiality, and have no respect of persons, but judge righteously. When thou undertakest to judge, love not gifts, bribes, and accept not persons, and admonish thy governors, or judges, that they be free from the taking of gifts, and that they accept not the persons of their friends, or of their enemies, or of rich or poor, in giving judgment. And they shall surely judge their neighbors in righteousness, and with a just judgment. Concerning the Ten Commandments. And hear ye, Israel, that which God commandeth you to keep. He saith, I am the Lord thy God, who hath brought thee out of the land of Egypt, and out of the house of bondage. There shall be no other gods beside me, and thou shalt not make any god that is graven, and no god that is like what is in the heavens above, or in the earth beneath, or in the water which is under the earth. Thou shalt not bow down to them, and thou shalt not serve them, for I, the Lord thy God, am a jealous God. I am he who visited the sin of the father on the children to the third and fourth generation of those who hate me. And I perform mercy to 1,000 or 10,000 generations of those who love me and keep my commandments. Thou shalt not swear a false oath in the name of the Lord thy God, for the Lord will not hold innocent the man who sweareth a false oath in his name. And observe the day of the Sabbath to sanctify it, even as the Lord thy God commanded. 6 days thou shalt do thy work, and on the seventh day, the Sabbath of the Lord thy God, thou shalt do no work at all, neither thyself, nor thy son, nor thy daughter, nor thine ass, nor any beast, nor the stranger that abideth with thee. For in 6 days God made the heavens, and the earth, and the sea, and all that in them is, and rested on the seventh day, because of this God blessed the seventh day, and declared it free from work. Honor thy father and thy mother, so that may be good to thee, the many days that thou shalt find in the land which the Lord thy God hath given thee. Thou shalt not go with the wife of another man. Thou shalt not slay a man. Thou shalt not commit fornication. Thou shalt not steal. Thou shalt not bear false witness against thy neighbor. Thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's wife, nor his house, nor his land, nor his manservant, nor his maidservant, nor his ox, nor his cattle, nor his ass, nor any of the beasts that thy neighbor hath acquired. This is the word which God hath spoken, his law and his ordinance, and those whose sin he rebuketh, so that they may not be confirmed in error, and may restrain themselves from the pollution wherewith God is not pleased. And this is the thing with which God is not pleased, and it is right that men should abstain from it. No man shall uncover the shame of one with whom he hath kinship, for I am the Lord your God. The shame of thy father and mother thou shalt not uncover, for it is thy mother. Thou shalt not uncover the shame of thy father's wife, for it is the shame of thy mother. Thou shalt not uncover the shame of thy sister, who was begotten by thy father or thy mother, whether she was born to him from outside, or whether she is a kinswoman of thine. Thou shalt not uncover her shame. Thou shalt not uncover the shame of either of thy son's daughter, or the shame of the daughter of thy daughter, for it is thine own shame. Thou shalt not uncover the shame of the daughter of thy father's wife, for she is thy sister, and the daughter of thy mother, and thou shalt not uncover her shame. Thou shalt not uncover the shame of thy father's sister, for she is of thy father's house. Thou shalt not uncover the shame of thy mother's sister, for she is of thy mother's house. Thou shalt not uncover the shame of the wife of thy father's brother, for she is thy kinswoman. Thou shalt not uncover the shame of thy son's wife, for she is thy son's wife. Thou shalt not uncover the shame of thy daughter and the wife of thy brother's son, for it is thine own shame. Thou shalt not uncover the shame of thy brother's wife, for it is thy brother's shame as long as thy brother liveth. Thou shalt not uncover the shame of a woman, and that of her daughter, nor of the daughter of her son, nor that of the daughter of her daughter. Thou shalt not cause their shame to be uncovered. It is thy house, and it is sin. And thou shalt not take to wife a maiden, and her sister, so as to make them jealous, each of the other. And thou shalt not uncover their shame, nor the shame of the one of the other, as long as the first sister is alive. Thou shalt not go to a menstruous woman until she is purified, to uncover her shame whilst she still unclean. And thou shalt not go to the wife of thy neighbor to lie with her, and thou shalt not let thy seed into her. And thou shalt not vow thy children to Moloch to defile the name of the Holy One, the name of the Lord. And thou shalt not lie with a man as with a woman, for it is pollution. And thou shalt not go to a beast, and thou shalt not lie with it, so as to make thy seed go out upon it, that thou mayest not be polluted thereby. And a woman shall not go to a beast to lie with it, for it is pollution. And ye shall not pollute yourselves with any of these things, for with them the nations whom I have driven out before you have polluted themselves, and with them ye shall not pollute your bodies. And sanctify ye your souls and your bodies to God, for he is the Holy One. and he loveth those who sanctify their souls and their bodies to him. For he is holy and to be feared, and he is high and merciful and compassionate, and to him praise is meet for ever and ever. Amen. How the men of the army of Israel received their orders. And the city rejoiced because the king had made his son king, and had appointed him king from his own territory to that of another. But the city sorrowed also because the king had commanded that they should give their children who were called firstborn. And those who were on the right hand should sit in the same way as their father sat with King Solomon. Even so should they sit at the right hand of his son David, the king of Ethiopia. And those who were on the left hand should sit at their father's as their father sat with King Solomon. Even so should they sit on the left hand of his son David, the king of Ethiopia. And their rank should be like that of their fathers, and their names should be like those of their fathers. And each should be according to his ordinance, and each according to his greatness, and each according to his position of authority, and each according to his wages, and each according to his rank. In this wise shall they be. As Solomon did to his nobles, so shall David do to his nobles. And as Solomon ordained for his governor, so shall David ordain the direction of his house. And the names of those who were appointed to be sent away with were these: Azariah, the son of Sadok, the priest, who was the high priest. Elias, the son of Arni, the archdeacon. Now the father of Arni was the archdeacon of Nathan the prophet. Adram, the son of Ardheronis, leader of the peoples. Phankera, the son of Soba, scribe of the oxen. Akonhel, the son of Tophel, the youth. Samneas, the son of Akitalam, the recorder. Phicaros, the son of Neah, commander of the armed men, that is to say, chief of the troops. Lewandos, the son of Akere, commander of the recruits. Fakuten, the son of Adrai, commander of the sea. Matan, the son of Benyas, chief of the house. Ad-Aras, the son of Kiram, servant of decorations. Dalekim, the son of Matrim, chief of the horse soldiers. Adarios, the son of Nedros, chief of the foot soldiers. Austeran, the son of Yodat, bearer of the glory. Astarion, the son of Asa, messenger of the palace. Imi, the son of Matatias, commander of the host. Makri, the son of Abisa, judge of the palace. Abis, the son of Kairos, is assessor of taxes, tithes. Lik Wendeos, the son of Nelenteos, judge of assembly. Carmi, the son of Hadneas, chief of the royal workmen. Seranias, the son of Akazel, administrator of the king's house. These are those who were given to David, king of Ethiopia, the son of Solomon, king of Israel. And Solomon also gave him horses and chariots, and riding camels and mules and wagons for carrying loads, and gold and silver and splendid apparel, and spices, and purple and gems and pearls and precious stones. And he gave his son everything that would be wished for in the country of Ethiopia. And then they made ready to set out. And though there was great joy with the nobles of the king of Ethiopia, there was sadness with the nobles of the king of Israel, because through the firstborn son of Solomon, king of Israel, that is to say, the king of Ethiopia, the first son of the nobles of Israel, were given to rule over the country of Ethiopia with the son of Solomon the king. Then they assembled together and wept together with their fathers and their mothers and their relations and their kinsfolk and their peoples and their countrymen. And they cursed the king secretly and reviled him because he had seized their sons against their will. But to the king they said, Because of this thou hast done well. Thy wisdom is so good that the kingdom of Israel, by the will of God, and by the wisdom extended to the country of Ethiopia. And God will gather together the other kingdoms of the world into thy hand, for thou hast a right mind towards God, and thou wishest that they shall serve the God of Israel, and that idols may be destroyed out of the world. And they praised him and said to him, Now know we that God spoke concerning thee to our father Abraham, when he said, In thy seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed. And they made their faces to appear happy, and they jested before him, and they praised him exceedingly, fulsomely, because of his wisdom. And when they said these things to him, he understood them in his wisdom, and bore with them patiently. Now God beareth with us patiently, knowing well all our sins. And the whole earth, and the heavens, and the ends of the world, and the sea, and the dry land, are the kingdom of God. He judgeth, and he hath given earth to the king to be subject to him, that he may judge or rule as he doth those who do evil, so that he may requite them with evil, and those who do good, so that he may reward them with good. For the Spirit of God resteth in the heart of the king, and his hands are in his mind, and his knowledge is in his understanding. How it is not a seemly thing to revile the king. Now it is not a seemly thing to revile the king, for he is the anointed of God. It is neither seemly nor good. If he doth that which is good, he will not suffer loss in three kingdoms. First, God shall overthrow for him his enemy, and he shall not be seized by the hand of his enemy. Secondly, God shall make him reign with him and with his righteousness, and shall make him to sit on his right hand. Thirdly, God shall make him to reign upon the earth with glory and joy, and shall direct his kingdom for him, and shall bring down the nations under his feet. And if he treated God lightly, and doth not do that which is good, and doth not himself walk in the path of uprightness, God shall work as he pleaseth against him on the earth, and will make his days to be few. And in heaven his place of abode shall be the habitation of Sheol with the devil. And on earth he shall enjoy neither health nor gladness, and he shall live in fear and terror, without peace and with perturbation. It is not a good thing for any of those who are under the dominion of a king to revile him, for retribution belongeth to God. Now the priests are like the prophets, only better than the prophets, for the mysteries are given to them, so that they may lay hold upon the Son of Righteousness, whilst the seraphim, who were created out of fire, are only able to lay hold upon the mysteries with tongues. As for the priest, he named them salt, and moreover, he named the priest lamp, and also light of the world, and also the sun that lighteneth the darkness, Christ, the Sun of Righteousness, being in their hearts. And a priest who hath in him understanding rebuketh the king concerning that he hath seen, and that which he hath not seen, God will require into. And there is none who can call him to account. Moreover, the people must not revile the bishops for the priests, for they are the children of God and the men of his house, and for which reason they must rebuke men for their sins and errors. And thou, O priest, if thou seest sin in a well-known man, shalt not hesitate to rebuke him. Let neither sword nor exile make thee afraid. And hear how angry God was with Isaiah, because he did not rebuke King Uzziah. And hearken also concerning Samuel the prophet, how he rebuked Saul the king, being in no way afraid of him, and how he rent his kingdom from him by his word. And hearken also how Elijah rebuked Ahab, and thou then fear not, and rebuke and teach him that transgresseth. And Israel from of old reviled their kings, and provoked their prophets to wrath, and in later times they crucified their Savior. But believing Christian folk dwell in peace, without sickness and suffering, without hatred and offense, with our King, who loveth God, and who removeth not from his heart the thing of righteousness and faith in the churches and in the believers. and his enemy shall be scattered by the might of the cross, Jesus Christus. How those who were sent away wept and made a plan. And the children of the nobles of Israel, who were commanded to depart with the son of the king, took counsel together, saying, What shall we do? For we have left our country and our birthplace, and our kinsfolk, and the people of our city. Now come ye, let us establish a covenant between us only, whereof our kinsfolk shall know nothing, that we will love each other in that country. None shall hasten or tarry here, and we will neither fear nor have any doubt, for God is here, and God is there, and may God's will be done. And to him be praise forever and ever. Amen. And Asaias and Elmias, sons of the priest, answered, Let not the other matter, that our kinsfolk hate us, cause us sorrow, but let us sorrow on account of our lady Zion, because they are making us to leave her. For in her they have committed us to God, and we have served her to this day. And let us be sorrowful because they have made us to leave her. It is because of her and because of this that they have specially made us to weep. And the others answered and said to them, Verily, she is our lady and our hope and our object of boasting, and we have grown up under her blessedness. And how is it possible for us to forsake Zion, our mistress? For we have been given to her, and what shall we do? If we resist his command, the king will kill us, and we are unable to transgress the word of our fathers or the king's command. And what shall we do concerning Zion, our lady? And Azarias, the son of Sadok, the priest, answered and said, I will counsel you what we shall do. But make a covenant with me to the end of your lives, and swear to me that you will not repeat in whether we live or whether we die, or whether we be taken captive or whether we go forth unhindered. And they swore an oath to him in the name of the Lord God of Israel, and by the heavenly Zion, the tabernacle of the law of God, and by what God had promised to Abraham, and by the purity and excellence of Isaac, by his making Jacob to arrive in and inherit a land whereto he was a stranger and a seed after him. And when they had sworn thus to him, he answered and said to them, Come now, let us take with us our lady Zion. But how are we to take her? I will show you. And carry ye out my plan, and if God willeth, we shall be able to take our lady with us. And if they should gain knowledge of our doings and slay us, that shall not trouble us, because we shall die for our lady Zion. And they all rose up and kissed his head and his face and his eyes. And they said to him, We will do everything that thou hast counseled us to do. Whether we die or whether we live, we are with thee for the sake of our Lady Zion. If we die, it will not cause us sorrow, and if we live, the will of God be done. And one of them, the son of Joas, Benaniah, whose name was Zechariah, said, I cannot sit down because of the great gladness that is in my heart. Tell me, moreover, canst thou indeed carry her off? And is it not a lie that thou canst go into the house of God in the place of thy father Zadok, and the keys are continually in thy hand. But ponder well what we counsel thee, before they take the keys out of thy hand. Thou knowest the hidden openings, or windows, which King Solomon made, but none of the priests may enter therein except thy father once each year, in order to offer up sacrifice in the Holy of Holies on behalf of himself and on behalf of the people. Ponder, consider, and sleep not in the matter of thy wish to carry away Zion, and we will depart with her as soon as she hath been committed to our care, and we shall have joy and our father's sorrow when she arriveth with us in the country of Ethiopia. And Osiris said to them, Do ye what I tell you, and we shall succeed. Give ye to me each of you 10 drachmas, and I will give them to a carpenter, so that he will make haste to prepare for me good planks of wood. Now because of his love of money, he will fasten them together very quickly of the height and breadth and length and size of our Lady Zion. And I will give him the dimensions of myself, and I will say to him, Prepare for me pieces of wood for a framework, so that I may make a raft therefrom, for we are going to travel over the sea, and if the event of the ship sinking, I shall be able to get up on the raft, and we shall be saved from the sea, and I will take the framework without the pieces of wood thereof being fixed together, and I will have them put together in Ethiopia, and I will set them down in the habitation of Zion, and will drape them with the draperies of Zion, and I will take Zion, and will dig a hole in the ground, and will set Zion there, until we journey and take it away with us thy there. And I will not tell the matter to the king until we have traveled far. And they gave him 10 didrachmas, and this money amounted to 140 didrachmas. And he took them and gave them to a carpenter, who straightway fashioned a good piece of work from the remains of the wood of the house of the sanctuary. And Azarias rejoiced and showed it to his brethren, how they made a plan concerning Zion. And while Azarias was asleep at night, the angel of the Lord appeared to him and said to him, take to thee 4 goats, each a yearling. Now they shall be for your sins, thyself and Elmeas and Abis and Makri, and 4 pure sheep, yearlings also, and an ox whereon no yoke hath ever been laid. And thou shalt offer up the ox as a sacrifice on the east side of her, Zion, and the sheep and the goats to the right and left thereof, and at the west of it, which is close to its exit. And your lord David shall speak to Solomon the king, and shall say to him, one thing I ask from thee, O father, I would offer up a sacrifice to the holy city Jerusalem, and to my lady Zion, the holy and heavenly tabernacle of the law of God. And Solomon shall say to him, do so. And David shall say to him, let the son of the priest offer up sacrifice on my behalf, even as he knoweth, and he will give thee the command. And thou shalt offer up the sacrifice, and thou shalt bring forth the tabernacle of the law of God, after thou hast offered up the sacrifice. And I will again show thee what thou shalt do in respect of it, as to bringing it out. For this is from God, for Israel hath provoked God to wrath, and for this reason he will make the tabernacle of the law of God to depart from him. And when Azarias awoke from his dream, he rejoiced greatly, and his heart and his mind were clear, and he remembered everything that the angel of the Lord had shown him in the night, and how he had sealed him with the sign of the cross, and given him strength, and hardened him. And he went to his brethren, and when they were gathered together, he told them everything that the angel of God had shown him, how the tabernacle of the law of God had been given to them, and how God had made blind his eye in respect of the kingdom of Israel, and how its glory had been given to others. And they themselves were to take away the tabernacle of the law of God, and how the kingdom of Solomon was to be seized by them, with the exception of 2 rods, and how it was not to be left to Rehoboam his son, and how the kingdom of Israel was to be divided. And Azarias rejoiced with me. I rejoice because it hath been shown to me thus, for the grace of their priesthood and kingdom shall depart with us, and it shall be by the will of God. Thus said he, the angel, to me, and now come ye, let us go and tell David our Lord, so that he may say to his father, I will offer up a sacrifice. And they went and told David, the son of Solomon, and he rejoiced, and he sent to Benaniah, the son of Jodahe, to come to him, that he might send him to his father. And he came, and David sent him to his father Solomon, and he said to him, send me away, for I will depart to my own country, together with everything that thy goodness hath given me. And may the prayers accompany me always, whithersoever I shall go. But now, there is one petition which I would make to thee. If peradventure I have found grace with thee, and turn not away thy face from me, for I, thy servant, am going to depart, and I wish to offer up a sacrifice of propitiation of or salvation for my sins in this thy holy place of Jerusalem and of Zion, the tabernacle of the law of God, and peace be with thy majesty. Concerning the offering of Azarias and the king. And Benaniah the son of Jodahe went and told King Solomon, and the king rejoiced over it, and commanded them to make ready the altar of offering, so that his son might sacrifice. And he brought and gave to him that which he had vowed to God, 100 bulls, 100 oxen, 10,000 sheep, 10,000 goats, and 10 of every kind of animal, that they may be eaten, and 10 of every kind of bird, so that he might offer libations and sacrifices to the God of Israel, and 20 silver sakals of fine white flour, each weighing 12 shekels, and 40 baskets of bread. All these things did Solomon the king give to his son David. And again David sent a message, saying, Let Azarias the priest offer up sacrifice on my behalf. And Solomon said to him, Do that which thou wishest. And Azarias rejoiced because of this thing. And he went and brought from his father's flock an ox whereon never yoke had been lain, and 4 yearlings of the goats, and 4 clean yearlings of the sheep. And the king went to offer up sacrifice, and the priests made themselves ready, and the poor folk were gathered together, and the birds of the heaven rejoiced, and they were all united in their gladness that day. And Azarias mingled his offering with the offering of the king, and he made an offering with his vessel, even as the angel of God had commanded him to do so by night. And then, after they had offered up their sacrifices, they went back to their houses and slept. How they carried away Zion. And behold, the angel of the Lord appeared again to Azarias, and he stood above him like a pillar of fire, and he filled the house with his light. And he raised up Azarias and said to him, Stand up, be strong, and rouse up thy brother Elmaas and Abdesa and Machri, and take the pieces of wood, and I will open for thee the doors of the sanctuary, and take thou the tabernacle of the law of God. And thou shalt carry it without trouble and discomfort. And I, as much as I have been commanded by God to be with it forever, will be thy guide when thou shalt carry it away. And Azarias rose up straightway and woke up the 3 men, his brethren. And they took the pieces of wood and went into the house of God. Now they found all the doors open, but those that were outside and those that were inside, to the actual place where Azarias found Zion, tabernacle of the law of God, and it was taken away by them forthwith in the twinkle of an eye, the angel of the Lord being present and directing. And had it not been that God willed it, Zion could not have been taken away forthwith. And the 4 of them carried Zion away, and they brought it into the house of Azarias. And they went back into the house of God, and they set the pieces of wood on the place where Zion had been. And they covered them over with the covering of Zion. And they shut the doors and went back to their houses. And they took lamps and set them in the place where Zion was hidden. And they sacrificed the sheep thereto, and burned offerings of incense thereto. And they spread purple cloth over it and set it in a secret place for 7 days and 7 nights. How his father blessed his son. And then the king of Ethiopia rose up to depart to his country. And he came to his father that he might pray on his behalf. And he said to him, Bless me, father. And he made obeisance to him. And the king raised him up and blessed him and embraced his head and said, Blessed be the Lord my God, who blessed my father David and who blessed our father Abraham. May he be with thee always, and bless thy seed even as he has blessed Jacob, and made his seed to be as many as the stars of heaven and the sand of the sea. And as Abraham blessed Isaac my father, even so shall thy blessing be, the dew of heaven and the spaciousness of the earth. And may all animals and all the birds of the heavens and all the beasts of the field and the fish of the sea be in subjection to thee. Be thou full and not lacking in fullness. Be thou perfect and not lacking in perfection. Be gracious and not obstinate. Be in good health and not suffering. Be generous and not vindictive. Be pure and not defiled. Be righteous and not a sinner. Be merciful and not oppressive. Be sincere and not perverse. Be long-suffering and not prone to wrath. And the enemy shall be afraid of thee, and thine adversaries shall cast themselves under the sole of thy foot. And my Lady Zion, the holy and heavenly, the tabernacle of the law of God, shall be a guide to thee at all times, a guide in respect of what thou shouldest think in thy heart, and shouldest do with thy fingers, whether it be far or near to thee, whether it be low or high to thee, whether it be strong or weak to thee, whether it be outside or inside thee, whether it be to thee in the house or in the field, whether it be visible or invisible to thee, whether it be away from or near to thee, whether it be hidden from or revealed to thee, whether it be secret or published abroad to thee. To thee, our Lady Zion, the holy and heavenly, the pure tabernacle of the law of God, shall be a guide. And David was blessed, and he made obeisance and departed. How they bade farewell to his father, and how the city mourned. And they bade the king farewell and departed. And first of all, they set Zion by night upon a wagon, together with a mass of worthless stuff, and dirty clothes, and stores of every sort and kind. And when all the wagons were loaded, and the masters of the caravan rose up, and the horn was blown, the city became excited, and the youths shouted loudly, "Awesomeness! Crowned it, and grace surrendered it, Zion!" And the old men wailed, and the children cried out, and the widows wept, and the virgins lamented, because the sons of their nobles, the mighty men of Israel, had risen up to depart. But the city did not weep for them alone, but because the majesty of the city had been carried off with them. And although they did not know actually that Zion had been taken from them, they made no mistake in their hearts, and they wept bitterly. And they were then even as they were when God slew the firstborn of Egypt. There were not a house wherein there was not wailing, for man, even to the beast. The dogs howled, and the asses screamed, and all those who were left there mingled their tears together. It was as though the generals of a mighty army had besieged the great city, and had captured it by assault, and looted it, and taken its people prisoner, and slain them with the edge of the sword. Even thus was the city of Zion, Jerusalem. And King Solomon was dismayed at the weeping and outcry of the city, and he looked out from the roof of the palace, the fort of the king's house, and saw the whole city weeping and following them. And as a child whom his mother hath removed from her breast and left, followed in her footsteps, crying out and weeping, even so did the people cry out and weep. And they cast dust upon their heads, and they shed tears with their eyes. And when Solomon saw the majesty of those who had departed, he was deeply moved, and he trembled, and his bowels quaked, and his tears fell drop by drop upon his apparel. And he said, "Woe is me, for my glory hath departed, and the crown of my splendor hath fallen, and my belly is burned up, because this my son hath departed. And the majesty of my city and the freemen, the children of my might, are removed. From this moment our glory hath passed away, and our kingdom hath been carried off to a strange people who know not God. Even as the prophet said, the people who have not sought me have found me. From this time forth the law and wisdom and understanding shall be given to them. And my father prophesied concerning them, saying, Ethiopia shall bow before him, and his enemies shall eat the dust. And in another place he said, Ethiopia shall stretch out her hands to God, and he shall receive her with honor. And the kings of the earth shall praise God. And in a third place he said, Behold, the Philistines and the Tyrians and the people of Ethiopia, who were born without the law shall be given to them. And they shall say to Zion, Our mother, because of a man who shall be born, will this man then be my son who is begotten of me? How he said to Zadok the priest, Go and bring the covering or clothing which is upon it, Zion. And he said to Zadok the priest, Go, bring the covering which is upon Zion, and take thee this covering which is better than that, and lay it over the two cherubs which are below it. Now, this covering was made of threads of the finest gold wirework, twisted together and hammered out into a pattern, and they were not woven like the threads of purple. And the five mice, which were given to Zion, and the ten figures of their shame, the emeralds, which the nobles of the Philistines made for their redemption. Now, on the fringes are figures of gold that came forth from the land of Cades, which Moses and Sinai commanded should be made, or worked, in the fringe of the apparel of Aaron his brother. Gather all these together in the covering of Zion, and give them to my son David. For his mother said in her message by Tamrim her servant, give us some of the fringe of the covering of Zion, so that we may worship it, we and those who are in subjection to us, and all our kingdom. And now give it to him, and say to him, take and worship this covering of Zion. For thy mother sent a message concerning this, and hath said to thee thyself, give us some of the fringe of this covering, which we can worship, so that we may not, like the heathen, worship another god. And Zion, the tabernacle of the law of God, shall be to thee a guide wheresoever thou art. But it must remain with us perpetually, although we have not paid it all the honor which it is due. And you, although it be not with you, must honor it and revere it according to what is due to it and what is meet. For God said to Eli, by the mouth of Samuel the prophet, I wish you to remain, thou and thy father's house, to offer up incense to the tabernacle of my law, and to dwell before me forever. But now I have repented, I will turn my face away from thee, because thou hast treated my offering with contempt, and hast preferred thy sons to me. And now him that honoreth me I will honor, and him that esteemeth me lightly I will esteem lightly, and I will destroy all thy seed. This he said because the Levites had esteemed him lightly. And say to him, take this covering of Zion, and this votive gift, which shall be in the place of it, and place it in thy sanctuary. And when thou takest an oath, and makest another to take an oath, swear thou and make him to swear by it, so that thou dost not make mention of the names of other gods of the heathen. And when thou sacrificest, let thy face be towards us, and sacrifice to Jerusalem and the holy Zion. And when thou prayest, let thy face be towards Jerusalem, and pray towards us. How Zadok the priest departed. And Zadok the priest went and gave David the covering of Zion, and he delivered to him all the commands which Solomon had spoken. And David the son of Solomon rejoiced because of this, and he marveled and held himself to be blessed exceedingly, and said, when the covering of the tabernacle of the law of God was committed to his charge, this shall be to me my lady. And Azarias answered and said before his father, thou rejoiced over the covering, but how very much more wilt thou rejoice over the lady of the covering? And his father said to him, verily, he rejoiced over the lady of the covering, and he might subjugate all of us if he were not going to his own country. And he said to the king, make now a covenant with me that thou wilt give to this my son this possession, for his lady and his sponsor and his protection, that he may guard it all the days of his life, for himself and for his seed after him, and that thou wilt give him tithe, and that thou wilt give him a city of refuge in thy kingdom, and also the tenth of the cities in all thy kingdom, and that he shall be to thee the priest, and seer, and prophet, and teacher to thee, to thy seed after thee, and the anointer with oil, how Zadok the priest departed. And Zadok the priest went and gave David the covering of Zion, and he delivered to him all the commands which Solomon had spoken. And David, the son of Solomon, rejoiced because of this, and he marveled and held himself to be blessed exceedingly, and said, when the covering of the tabernacle of the law of God was committed to his charge, this shall be to me my lady. And Azarias answered and said before his father, thou rejoicest over the covering, but how very much more wilt thou rejoice over the lady of the covering? And his father said to him, verily, he rejoiced over the lady of the covering, and he might subjugate all of us if he were not going to his own country. And he said to the king, make now a covenant with me, that thou wilt give to this my son this possession, for his lady and his sponsor and his protection, that he may guard it all the days of his life, for himself and for his seed after him, and that thou wilt give him tithe, and that thou wilt give him a city or of refuge in thy kingdom, and also the tenth of thy cities in all thy kingdoms, and that he shall be to thee priest and seer and prophet and teacher to thee and to thy seed after thee, and the anointer with oil of thy kingdom for thy children and thy children's children. And he said, I agree. And they struck, made a covenant, and he received from his father the votive offering and the covering of Zion, and a chain of gold. And they loaded the wagons and the horses and the mules in order to depart, and they set out on their journey prosperously, and they continued to travel on. And Michael, the archangel, marched in front, and he spread out his wings and made them to march through the sea as upon dry land. And upon the dry land he cut a path for them, and spreading himself out like a cloud over them, he hid them from the fiery heat of the sun. And as for their wagons, no man hauled his wagon, but he himself, Michael, marched with the wagons. And whether it was men, horses, or mules, or loaded camels, each was raised above the ground to the height of a cubit, and all those who rode upon beasts were lifted up above their backs to the height of one span of a man. And all the various kinds of baggage which were loaded on the beast, as well as those who were mounted on them, were raised up to the height of one span of a man. And the beasts were lifted up to the height of one span of a man. And everyone traveled in the wagons like a ship on the sea when the wind bloweth, and like a bat through the air when the desire of his belly urgeth him to devour his companions, and like an eagle when his body glideth above the wind. Thus did they travel. There was none in front and none behind, and they were disturbed neither on the right hand nor on the left. How the wagon was given to Ethiopia. And they halted by Gaza, the city of the mother of the king, which Solomon the king had given to the queen of Ethiopia when she came to him. And from there they came in one day to the border of Gebes, Egypt, the name of which is Mesrin. And when the sons of the warriors of Israel saw that they had come in one day a distance of 13 days' march, and that they were not tired or hungry or thirsty, neither man nor beast, and that they all felt that they had eaten and drunk their fill, these sons of the warriors of Israel knew and believed that this thing was from God. And they said to their king, let us let down the wagons, for we have come to the water of Ethiopia. This is Takasi, which floweth down from Ethiopia and watereth the valley of Egypt. And they let down their wagons there and set up their tents. And the sons of the warriors of Israel went and drove away all the people, and they said to David their king, shall we tell thee a matter? Canst thou hold it secret? And the king said to them, yes, I can hold it secret. And if ye will tell it to me, I will never let it go forth or repeat it to the day of my death. And they said to him, the sun descended from heaven and was given on Sinai to Israel, and it became the salvation of the race of Adam, from Moses to the seed of Jesse. And behold, it is with thee by the will of God. It is not through us that this has been done, but by the will of God. It is not through us that this hath been done, but by the will of him that fashioned it, and made it happen. We wished, and God hath fulfilled our wish. We agreed concerning it, and God made it good. We held converse concerning it, and God performed it. We meditated upon it, and God devised a plan. We spoke, and God was well pleased. We directed our gaze, and God directed it rightly. We meditated, and God hath justified. And now God hath chosen thee, and is well pleased with thy city, to be the servant of the holy and heavenly Zion, the tabernacle of the law of God. And it shall be to thee a guide forever, to thee and to thy seed after thee, if thou wilt keep his command and perform the will of the Lord thy God. For thou wilt not be able to take it back, even if thou wishest, and thy father cannot seize it, even if he wisheth, for it goeth of its own free will whithersoever it wisheth, and it cannot be removed from its seat if it doth not desire it. And behold, it is our Lady, our Mother, and our salvation, our fortress, and our place of refuge, our glory, and the heaven of our safety, to those who lean upon it. And Azarias made a sign to Elmeas, and he said to him, Go, beautify and dress our Lady, so that our king may see her. And when Azarias had said this, King David was perturbed, and he laid both hands upon his breast, and he drew breath three times and said, Hast thou in truth, O Lord, remembered us in thy mercy, the castaways, the people whom thou hast rejected, so that I may see thy pure habitation, which is in heaven, the holy and heavenly Zion? With what shall we requite the Lord in return for all the good things which he hath done for us? There being with him no glory and praise, he hath crowned us with his grace, so that we may know upon earth his praise, and may all serve him according to his greatness. For he is the good one to his chosen ones, and to him belongeth praise forever. And King David rose up and skipped about like a young sheep, and like a kid of the goats, that hath sucked the milk in abundance from his mother, even as his grandfather David rejoiced before the tabernacle of the law of God. He smote the ground with his feet, and rejoiced in his heart, and uttered cries of joy with his mouth. And what shall I say of the great joy and gladness that were in the camp of the king of Ethiopia? One man told his neighbor, and they smote the ground with their feet like young bulls, and they clapped their hands together, and marveled, and stretched out their hands to heaven. And they cast themselves down in their faces to the ground, and they gave thanks to God in their hearts. How David, the king of Ethiopia, prophesied and saluted Zion. And King David came and stood up before Zion, and he saluted it, and made obeisance thereto, and said, O Lord God of Israel, to thee be praise, because thou dost thy will, and not the will of men. Thou makest the wise man to forget his wisdom, and thou destroyest the counsel of the counselor, and thou raisest the poor man from the death, and thou settest the sole of his foot upon a strong rock. For a full cup of glory is in thy hand for those who love thee, and a full cup of shame for those who hate thee. As for us, our salvation shall go forth out of Zion, and he shall remove sin from his people, and goodness and mercy shall be poured out in all the world. For we are the work of his hands, and who shall rebuke us if he loveth us as Israel his people? And who shall reprove him if he raiseth us to heaven his throne? For death and life are from him, and glory and dishonor are in his hand. He hath the power to punish and to multiply his compassion, and he can be wroth and multiply his mercy, for it is he who trieth the heart and the reins. He giveth, and he taketh away. He planteth, and he uprooteth. He buildeth up, and he throweth down. He beautifieth, and he deformeth. For everything belongeth to him, and everything is from him, and everything is existed in him. And as for thee, O tabernacle of the law of God, salvation be whither thou goest, and from the place whence thou goest forth, salvation be in the house and in the field, salvation be here and be there, salvation be in the palace and in the lowly place, salvation be on the sea and on dry land, salvation be in the mountains and in the hills, salvation be in the heavens and on earth, salvation be ill the firm grounds and in the abysses. Salvation be in death and in life. Salvation be in thy coming and in thy going forth. Salvation be to our children and to the tribe of thy people. Salvation be in thy countries and in thy cities. Salvation be to the kings and to the nobles. Salvation be the plants and to the fruits. Salvation be to men and to beasts. Salvation be to the birds and to the creeping things of the earth. Be salvation, be an intercessor and a merciful one, and have regard for thy people. Be to us a wall, and we will be to thee a fence. Be thou a king to us, and we will be thy people. Be thou a guide to us, and we will follow after thee. And be not impatient, and mark not closely, and be not angry at the multitude of our sins, for we are a people who have not the law, and who have not learned thy praise. And from this time forward guide us, and teach us, and make us to have understanding, and make us to have wisdom, that we may learn thy praise. And thy name shall be praised by us at all times, and all the day, and every day, and every night, and every hour, and all the length of time. Give us power that we may serve thee. Rise up, Zion, and put on thy strength, and conquer thine enemies, and give us strength, our queen, and put thou to shame those who hate thee, and make to rejoice those who love thee. And then he made a circuit and said, Behold, Zion, behold salvation, behold the one who rejoiced it, behold the splendor like the sun, behold the one adorned with praise, behold the one who is decorated like a bride, not with the apparel of fleeting glory, but the one who is decorated with the glory and praise which are from God, whom it is meet that men shall look upon with desire and shall not forsake, whom men shall desire above all things and shall not reject, whom men shall love willingly and shall not hate, whom men shall approach willingly and shall not keep afar off. We will draw nigh to thee, and do not thou withdraw from us. We will support ourselves upon thee, and do not thou let us slip away. We will supplicate thee, and do not thou be deaf to us. We will cry out to thee. Hear thou our cry in all that we ask of thee, and desire not to withdraw thyself from us until thy Lord cometh and reigneth over thee, for thou art the habitation of the God of heaven. Thus spoke David the king, the son of Solomon, king of Israel, for the spirit of prophecy descended upon him because of his joy, and he knew not what he had said, and he was like Peter and John on the top of Mount Tabor. And they all marveled and said, This, the son of a prophet, is he to be numbered among the prophets? How the people of Ethiopia rejoiced. And the people of Ethiopia took flutes, and blew horns, and blew drums, and beat drums, and played on pipes. And the brook of Egypt was moved and astonished at the noise of their songs and their rejoicing. And with them were mingled outcries and shouts of gladness. And their idols, which they had made with their hands, and which were in forms of men and dogs and cats, fell down. And the high towers, pylons, or obelisks, and also the figures of birds made of gold and silver fell down also and were broken in pieces, for Zion shone like the sun, and at the majesty thereof they were dismayed. And they arrayed Zion in her apparel, and they bore the gifts to her before her, and they set her upon a wagon, and they spread out purple beneath her, and they draped her with draperies of purple, and they sang songs before her and behind her. Then the wagons rose up, resumed their journey as before, and they set out early in the morning. And the people sang songs to Zion, and they were all raised up the space of one cubit. And as the people of the country of Egypt bade them farewell, they passed before them like shadows, and the people of the country of Egypt worshipped them, for they saw Zion moving in the heavens like the sun. And they all ran with the wagon of Zion, some in front of her and some behind her. And they came to the sea Elhamar, which is the sea of Eritrea, the Red Sea, which was divided by the hand of Moses. And the children of Israel marched in the depths thereof, going up and down. Now at the time the tabernacle of the law of God had not been given to Moses, and therefore the water only gathered itself together, a wall on the right hand and a wall on the left, and allowed Israel to pass with their beasts and their children and their wives. And after they had crossed the sea, God spake to Moses and gave him the tabernacle of the covenant with the book of the law. And when the holy Zion crossed over with those who were in attendance on her, and who sang songs to the accompaniment of harps and flutes, the sea received them, and its waves leaped up as do the high mountains when they are split asunder. And it roared even as a lion roareth when he is enraged, and it thundereth as doth the winter thunder of Damascus and Ethiopia when the lightning smitten the clouds, and the sound thereof mingled with the sounds of the musical instruments, and the sea worshipped Zion, and wilts it billows with tossing about like the mountains. Their wagons were raised above the waves for a space of 3 cubits. Among the sound of the songs, the noise of the breaking of the waves of the sea was wonderful. The breaking of the waves of the sea was exceedingly majestic and stupefying, and it was mighty and strong. And the creatures that were in the sea that could not be recognized, and those that were invisible, came forth and worshipped Zion. And the birds that were on it flapped their pinions and overshadowed it. And there was joy to the sea of Eritrea and to the people of Ethiopia, who went forth to the sea and rejoiced exceedingly, and with a greater joy than did Israel when they came out of Egypt, and they arrived opposite Mount Sinai and dwelt in Kadesh, and they remained there whilst the angels sang praises. And the creatures of the spirit mingled their praises with those of the children of earth, with songs and psalms and tambourines joyfully. And then they loaded their wagons, and they rose up and departed and journeyed on to the land of Midian. And they came to the country of Belantos, which is a country of Ethiopia. And they rejoiced there, and they encamped there, because they had reached the border of their country with glory and joy, without tribulation on the road, in a wagon of the Spirit, by the might of heaven and of Michael the archangel. And all the provinces of Ethiopia rejoiced, for Zion sent forth a light like that of the sun into the darkness wheresoever she came. Of the return of Zadok the priest and giving of the gift. And when Zadok the priest returned to Solomon the king, he found himself sorrowful. And the king answered and said to Zadok the priest, "When the queen came, there appeared to me by night this vision. It seemed as if I were standing in the chamber of Jerusalem, and the sun came down from heaven into the land of Judah, and lighted up with great splendor. And having tarried a time, it went down and lighted up the country of Ethiopia, and it did not return to the land of Judah. And again the sun came down from heaven to the country of Judah, and lighted up more brilliantly than it did the first time. But the Israelites paid no heed to it, and they wished to extinguish its light. And it rose below the earth in a place where it was not expected. And it illumined the country of Rome and the country of Ethiopia, and afterwards all those who believe on it." And Zadok the priest answered and said to him, "O my lord, why didst thou not tell me before that thou hadst seen a vision of this kind? Thou makest my knees to tremble. Woe be to us if our sons have carried off our lady, the holy heavenly Zion, the tabernacle of the law of God." And the king answered and said to him, "Our wisdom is forgotten, and our understanding is buried. Verily, the sun that appeared to me long ago when I was sleeping with the queen of Ethiopia was the symbol of the holy Zion. But tell me, yesterday when thou didst take off the splendid covering that was lying upon Zion, didst thou not make certain that Zion was there?" And Zadok the priest answered and said, "I did not, Lord. It had 3 coverings over it, and I took off the uttermost and dressed Zion in the covering which thou didst give me, and I brought the other to thee." And the king said to Zadok, "Go quickly and look at our lady and examine her closely." And Zadok the priest took the keys and went and opened the house of the sanctuary, and he examined the place quickly and he found there nothing except the wooden boards which Azarias had fastened together and had made to resemble the sides of the pedestal of Zion, concerning the fall of Zadok the priest. And when Zadok saw this, he fell forward on his face flat upon the ground, and his spirit was poured out over him, for he was terrified, and he became like a dead man. And when he tarried in coming out, Solomon sent him to Benaniah, the son of Jodahe, and he found Zadok like one dead. And he lifted up the head of Zadok and felt his heart and his nose to find out whether there was any sign of breath being in him. And he fanned him and lifted him up and rubbed him and laid him out upon the table. And he rose up and looked at the place where Zion had been set, and he found her not, and he fell upon the ground. And he cast dust upon his head, and then rose up and went out and wailed at the doors of the house of God. And the sound of his cries was heard as far as the king's house. And the king rose up and commanded the crier to go round, and the soldiers to blow the trumpets, so that the people might go forth and persuade the men of the land of Ethiopia. And if they overtook them, they were to seize his son and bring him back with Zion, and slay the other men with the sword. For with his mouth he spake and said, "As the Lord God of Israel liveth, they are men of death and not of life. For verily they deserve death because they have robbed the house of the sanctuary of God, and have desired to pollute the habitation of his name in the land wherein there is not the law." How Solomon rose up to slay them. Thus spake King Solomon, and the king rose up in wrath and set out to pursue the men of Ethiopia. And when the king and his nobles and his mighty men of war rose up, the elders of Israel and the widows and the virgins gathered together in the house of God, and they wept for Zion, for the tabernacle of the law of God had been taken away from them. Now after Zadok had remained senseless for a season, his heart returned to him. And then the king commanded that soldiers should go forth on the right hand and on the left hand, on the chance that some of the fugitives might turn aside through fear of the theft. And the king himself rose up and followed the track of the road of the men of Ethiopia. And he sent out mounted horsemen so that they might ride on before him and find out where they were, and might return and bring him news of them. And the horsemen journeyed on and came to the country of Messer, Egypt, where the men of Ethiopia had encamped with their king, and where they had made peace with Zion, and they rejoiced. And the soldiers of King Solomon questioned the people, and the men of the country of Egypt said to them, "Some days ago certain men of Ethiopia passed here, and they traveled swiftly in wagons like the angels, and they were swifter than the eagles of the heavens." And the king's soldiers said to them, "How many days ago is it since they left you?" And the men of Egypt said to them, "This day is the ninth day since they left us." And some of the king's horsemen who returned said to King Solomon, "9 days have passed since they left Egypt. Some of our companions have gone to seek for them at the Sea of Eritrea, but we came back that we might report this to thee. Bethink thyself, O king, I beseech thee. On the second day they went forth from thee, and they arrived on the third day at the river Takasi of the land of Messer, Egypt. And we, being sent forth by thee from Jerusalem, arrived on the day of the Sabbath. And we came back to thee today, which is the fourth day of the week. Consider in thy wisdom the distance which those men traversed." And the king was wroth and said, "Seize the 5 of them, until we find out the truth of their words." And the king and his soldiers marched quickly, and they came to Gaza. And the king asked the people, saying, "When did my son leave you?" And they answered and said to him, "He left us 3 days ago, and having loaded their wagons, none of them traveled on the ground, but in wagons that were suspended in the air, and they were swifter than the eagles that are in the sky, and all their baggage traveled with them in the wagons above the wind. As for us, we thought that thou hadst, in thy wisdom, made them to travel in wagons above the winds." And the king said to them, Was Zion the tabernacle of the law of God with them? And they said to him, We did not see anything. How the king questioned an Egyptian, the servant of Pharaoh. And Solomon left the place, and he met a noble of the nobles of Egypt, whom King Pharaoh had sent to him with a gift. And there was an abundance of treasures with him. And he came and made obeisance to the king. And Solomon the king made haste to question him, even before he had presented his gift and embassy, and said to him, Hast thou seen men of Ethiopia fleeing by this road? And the ambassador of Pharaoh answered and said to the king, O king, live forever. My lord King Pharaoh sent me to thee from Alexandria, and behold, I will inform thee how I have come. Having set out from Alexandria, I come to Kahira, Cairo, the city of the king, and on my arrival, these men of Ethiopia, of whom thou speakest, arrived there also. They reached there after a passage of 3 days on the Takasi, the river of Egypt, and they were blowing flutes, and they traveled on wagons like the host of the heavenly beings, and those who saw them concerning them, these, having once been creatures of earth, have been beings of heaven, have become beings of heaven. Who then is wiser than Solomon, the king of Judah? But he never traveled in this wise in a wagon of the winds. And those who were in the cities and towns were witnesses that when these men came into the land of Egypt, our gods and the gods of the king fell down and were dashed in pieces. And the towers of the idols were likewise broken into fragments. And they asked the priest of the gods, the diviners of Egypt, the reason why our gods have fallen. And they said to us, the tabernacle of the God of Israel, which came down from heaven, is with them and will abide in their country forever. And it was because of this, when they came into the land of Egypt, our gods were broken into fragments. And thou, O king, whose wisdom has no counterpart under the heavens, why hast thou given away the tabernacle of the law of the Lord of thy God, which thy fathers kept pure for thee? For according to what we hear, the tabernacle used to deliver you out of the hands of your enemies, and the spirit of prophecy, which was therein, used to hold converse with you, and the God of heaven used to dwell in it, and his Holy Spirit, and ye are called men of the house of God. Why have ye given your glory to another? And Solomon answered in wisdom and said, How was he, David, able to carry away our lady? For she is with us. How Solomon lamented for Zion. And Solomon entered into his tent and wept bitterly and said, O God, willest thou to take away the tabernacle of thy covenant from us in my days? If only thou hadst taken away my life before this, thou hast taken away in my days. For thou canst not make thy word to be a lie, and thou cannot break thy covenant which thou didst make with our fathers, with Noah thy servant, who kept righteousness, and with Abraham, who did not transgress thy commandment, and with Isaac thy servant, who kept his body pure from pollution of sin, and with Israel thy holy one, whom thou didst make many by the Holy Spirit, and didst call the trace Israel, and with Moses and Aaron thy priest, in whose days thou didst make the tabernacle of the law to come down from heaven upon earth to the children of Jacob, thine inheritance, with thy law and thy commandment, in the form of the constitution of the angels. For thou hast already founded Zion as the habitation of thy glory upon the mountain of thy sanctuary. And again thou didst give it to Moses, that he might serve it nobly upon the earth, and might make it to dwell in the tent of witness, so that thou thyself mightest come there from the mountain of thy sanctuary, and mightest make the people to hear thy voice, so that they might walk in thy commandments. Now I know that thou esteemest thine inheritance more lightly than thy people Israel, and until it was with us, and we did not minister to it rightly, and for this reason thou art angry with us, and thou hast turned thy face from us. O Lord, look not upon our evil deeds, but consider thou that the goodness of our forefathers. My father David, thy servant, wished to build a house to thy name, for he had heard the word of thy prophet, who said, Which is the house of my habitation, and which is the place for me to rest in? Is it not my hands that have made all this, said the Lord, who ruleth everything? And when he had meditated upon this, thou didst say to him, It is impossible for thee to build this, but he who hath gone forth from thy loins shall build a house for me. And now, O Lord, thy word hath not been made a lie, and I have built thy house, thou being my helper. And when I had finished building thy house, I brought the tabernacle of the covenant into it, and I offered up sacrifices to thy thrice holy name. And thou didst look on thee benevolently, and the house was full of thy glory, the whole world being filled with thy Godhead. And we thy people rejoiced at the sight of thy glory therein. And this day it is 3 years since that time. And thou hast snatched away thy light from us, that thou mayest illumine those that are in darkness. Thou hast removed our honor, that thou mayest honor those who are unworthy. Thou hast blotted out our majesty, that thou mayest make majestic him that is not majestic. Thou hast taken away our life, that thou mayest build up him whose life is far from thee. Woe is me! Woe is me! I weep for myself. Rise up, David, my father, and weep with me for our lady, for God hath neglected us, and hath taken away our lady from thy son. Woe is me, woe is me, woe is me, for the son of righteousness hath neglected me. Woe is me, for he hath neglected the command of our God, and we have become rejected ones on the earth. As priests we have not acted well, and as kings we have not done what is right in respect of judgment to the orphans. Woe be to us, woe be to us. What is right hath passed from us, and we are rebuked. Woe be to us. Our joy hath turned aside to our enemies, and the grace that ours hath been removed from us. Woe be to us, woe be to us. Our back is turned towards the spears of our enemies. Woe be to us, woe be to us. Our children have become the spoil and captives of those whom we recently have spoiled and made captives. Woe be to us, woe be to us. Our widows weep and our virgins mourn. Woe be to us, woe be to us. Our old men wail and our young men lament. Woe be to us, woe be to us. Our women shed tears and our city is laid waste. Woe be to us, woe be to us. For this day, the end of our days, we must mourn, and our children likewise. Woe be to us, woe be to us. For the glory of the glorious daughter of Zion is removed, and the glory of the daughter of Ethiopia, the vile, hath increased. God is wroth, and who shall show compassion? God hath made unclean, and who shall purify? God hath planned, and who shall gainsay his plan? God hath willed, and who shall oppose his intention? God speaketh, and everything shall come to pass. God hath abased, and there is none that shall promote to honor. God hath taken away, and there is none who shall bring back. God hateth, and there is none who shall make him to love. Woe be to us, our name was honored. Today it is nothing. Woe be to us, from being men of the household, we have become men of the outside. And from being men of the inner chambers, we have been driven out through our sins. For God loveth the pure, but the priest would have none of the pure, and have loved the impure. And the prophets rebuked us, but we would not accept rebuke. And they wished to make us hear, but we would not hear. Woe be to us! Through our sins we are rejected, and because of our defection we shall be punished. Sovereignty profiteth nothing without purity, and judgment profiteth nothing without justice, and riches profiteth nothing without the fear of God. The priests love the words of the fables more than the words of the scriptures, and they love the sound of the harp more than the sound of the psalter, and they love the service of the world more than prayer, and they love the disputing of the world more than the voice of the Godhead, and they love laughter and fornication more than the weeping of life, and they love the food that passeth away from more than the fasting to God, and they love wine and sweet drink more than sacrificing to God, and they love idleness more than prayer, and they love possessions more than the giving of alms, and they love sleeping more than praising, and they love dozing more than watching. Woe be to us, woe be to us. O Queen, we have been negligent, negligent. O Queen, we have been negligent in respect of the commandment of God. We have loved the words of the fable mongers more than the word of the priest. We have wished to gaze upon the face of our women rather than upon the face of God in repentance. We have loved to look upon our children rather than to hear the word of God. We have consoled ourselves more with the sardius stone than with the administering right judgment to the orphans. We have loved to look upon our honor rather than to hear the voice of God. We have loved the word of foolishness more than the words of the wise. We have loved the words of fools more than hearing the words of the prophets. Woe be to us. Of our own free will we have polluted our life. Woe be to us. Woe be to us. The repentance and mercy which God loveth we have not done. Woe be to us. He gave us glory and we have thrown it away. He made us very wise. And of our own free will we have made ourselves more foolish than the beast. We gave us riches, and we gave beggared ourselves even to asking for alms. We looked upon our horses and forgot our coming back. We have loved fleeting things, and we have not recognized those that abide. We have made our days to deride our lives. We have preferred the luxuriousness of food which becometh dung to the food of life which endureth forever. We have put on the garments of apparel which benefit not the soul, and have put off the apparel of glory which is forever. Our governors and people do not do what God hateth, and they love not what God loveth. Love of thy neighbors, and lowliness, and graciousness, and mercy for the poor, and patience, endurance, and love of the house of God, and the adoration of the sun. But what God hateth is augury by birds, and adultery, and inquiry of witches, and divination, and magic, and files, and akireno, the animal that hath been torn, and the dead body of a beast, and theft, and oppression, and fornication, and envy, fraud, drink, and drunkenness, false swearing against neighbors, and the bearing of false testimony against neighbors. All these things which God hateth, they do. And it is because of them that God hath taken the tabernacle of his covenant away from us, and hath given it to the people who do his will and his law and his ordinance. He hath turned his face from us, and hath made his face to shine upon them. He hath despised us, and hath loved them. He hath shown mercy to them, and hath blotted us out, because he hath taken away the tabernacle of his covenant from us. For he hath sworn an oath by himself that he will not abrogate winter and summer, seedtime and harvest, fruit and work, sun and moon, as long as Zion is on the earth, and that he will not in wrath destroy heaven and earth, either by flood or fire, and that he will not blot out man and beast and reptiles and creeping things, but he will show mercy to the work of his hands, and will multiply his mercy on what he hath formed. And when God taketh away the tabernacle of his covenant, he will destroy the heavens and the earth and all his work. And this day hath God despised us and taken from us the tabernacle of his law. And whilst Solomon was saying these things, he ceased not to weep, and the tears ran down his cheeks continually. And the spirit of prophecy answered and said to him, Why art thou thus sorrowful? For this hath happened by the will of God, and Zion hath not been given to an alien, but to thy firstborn son, who shall sit upon the throne of David, thy father. For God swore to David in truth, and he repenteth not that of the fruit of his body he would make to sit upon the throne forever, in the tabernacle of his covenant, the holy Zion. And I will set him above the kings of the earth, and his throne shall be like the days of heaven, and like the ordinance of the moon forever. And he who sitteth upon the throne of the Godhead is in the heavens, shall rule the living and the dead in the flesh forever. And angels and men shall serve him, and every tongue shall praise him, and every knee shall bow to him in the abysses and in the rivers. Comfort thyself with this word, and get thee back to thy house, and let not thy heart be wholly sad. And the king was comforted by this word, and he said, the will of God be done, and not the will of man. And again the angel of God appeared to him openly and said to him, As for thyself, thou shalt build the house of God, and it shall be glory, and as a support for thee. And if thou wilt keep his commandment, and wilt not serve other gods, thou shalt be loved by God, even as David thy father. How Solomon returned to Jerusalem. And then Solomon came back to the city of Jerusalem, and he wept there with the elders of Jerusalem, a great weeping in the house of God. And after this, the king of Zadok, the priest, embraced each other, and they wept bitterly in the habitation of Zion, and they remained silent for a long time. And the elders rose up and spake to the king, saying, Be not thou sorrowful concerning this thing, O our Lord, for we know from first to last that without the will of God, Zion will not dwell in any place, and that nothing happeneth without the will of God. And as concerning Zion in olden time, in the days of Eli the priest, before our fathers had asked for a king, the Philistines carried Zion away captive into their camp, God having neglected Israel in the battle. And its priest, Hophni and Phinehas, having fallen by the edge of the sword. And the Philistines carried away the tabernacle of the law of God, and brought it into their city, and set it in the house of their god, Dagon. And Dagon was broken to pieces, and destroyed, and became like dust. And their land became a desert through mice. And they ate up all the fruit of their land, and their persons became sores and boils. And they gathered together their priests and magicians and stargazers. And they entreated them and said to them, How can we relieve ourselves of these sores and tribulation which have come upon us and our country? And those magicians meditated and withdrew themselves to be alone. And there brought their magical instruments and pondered and considered and planned how they could relieve them from the tribulation of their city and their persons. And they discovered that this punishment had come upon them of their city because of Zion. And they went to their king, their governors, and they said to them, All these things have befallen you through the heavenly Zion, the tabernacle of the law of God. And now know ye how ye will take her back into her city, and her country, and her house. And we must by no means send her away empty, but must give her an offering, so that she may forgive your sins, and do away your tribulation when she hath returned to her city. And if ye will not send her to her city, no good will come of making her to live with you, but ye shall continue to be punished until ye are destroyed. And their kings and governors said to their priests, What gifts now say ye that we ought to give her, and how shall we send her back? Find out and tell us what we must do. And the priests of the Philistines took counseled together again, and they said to their kings and governors, Make for her, according to the heads of your houses, 60 figures of mice and gold, since mice have destroyed your land, and 60 figures of the member of a man, since your own persons have suffered from sores and boils on your members. And the Philistines made as they commanded them 120 offerings of gold, and gave them to Zion. And again they said to the priest, How shall we send her away? And whom do we say shall set her in her city? And again the magicians of the Philistines said to them, Let them bring two she-camels that brought forth their firstborn at the same time, and let them attach a wagon to them. And they must keep back their young ones and shut them up in the house, and they must yoke the two she-camels together, and then set them free and let them go where they will. And if they march straight for Jerusalem, we shall know that peradventure God hath had compassion on our land. But if they wander about and go hither and thither and wish to turn back to the place whence they started, then we shall know that God is still wroth with us, and that he will not remove his punishment until he hath blotted out ourselves and our city. And the Philistines did as the priests commanded their governors, and they sent away Zion and prostrated themselves before her. And those camels made their way straight to the country of Judah, and they came to the threshing floor, and the house of thy kinsfolk received them. And those who did not receive them were the men of the house of Dan, and they did not do homage to Zion, for they regarded her in anger as their destroyed God. And they cut up the pieces of wood of the wagon, and they made those camels to be sacrifices, and Zion returned to her place. And while Zion was in her house, Samuel the prophet ministered to us, and vision and prophecy were revealed to him. And he pleased God in all his actions, and he ruled Israel for 48 years. And after him, our people entreated God to give them a king like the nations that were round about them. And Samuel the prophet anointed Saul king, and he reigned 40 years. And he was of the tribe of Benjamin, which was the youngest branch of the peoples of Israel. And Samuel the prophet also anointed thy father David. And when the Philistines fought with Saul the king, Saul was conquered and died with Nathan his son, and those of his sons who were left wished to carry away Zion, when they knew that their father and their brother were dead. And then, when they wished to hide her and to transfer her to the valley of Gilboa, in order that thy father David might not carry them off, she would not let them carry her away until thy father came and carried her away from him, from their city, but not with offerings, and not with increase and burnt offerings, for it was impossible to carry Zion away unless she wished it and God wished it. And again, when thy father reigned rightly over Israel, he took her from the city of Samaria and brought her here to Jerusalem, dancing on his feet before her and clapping his hands because of the joy for her. For she was taken by him that she might come to the city of David thy father. And as for that which thou sayest concerning the going of Zion to their city, to the country of Ethiopia, if God willed it, and she herself willed it, there is no one who could prevent her. For of her own will she went, and of her own will she return if God please it. And if she doth not return, it will be God's good pleasure. And as for us, if God hath willed it, Jerusalem shall remain to us, wherein thou hast built for us a house of God. And now let not thine heart be sad, but comfort thyself with what we have said to thee, and the wisdom which the Lord God of Israel hath given thee, hath sprouted from thee. For wisdom is a strange thing, as a lamp is not the sun, and as vinegar and aloes are neither profitable nor useful additions to honey, even so the words of fools are not beneficial to the wise man. And as smoke is to the eye, the unripe fruit to the tooth, even so the words of fools are not beneficial to the wise.